Hello students, from this lecture we are going to study chapter 12 biotechnology and its applications. In this chapter main topics are related with biotechnological applications in the field of agriculture, biotechnological application in medicine field, transgenic animals and ethical issues. We have already studied about biotechnological principles and processes in chapter number 11. So, you have already idea about this field of biology that is known as biotechnology, where various technologies were used, deals with living organism, plants, animals or human being, and it is applied at large scale in industrial production, which is useful for mankind. Biotechnology is actually essentially deals with industrial scale production of biopharmaceuticals and biological using genetically modified microbes, fungi, plants and animals. Applications of biotechnology include therapeutics, diagnostics, genetically modified crops, or we can also say GM crops, for agriculture food, processed food, bioremediation, waste treatment and energy production. So, you can assume that how it is useful to mankind in industrial production also. So, this way biotechnology, by using this technology in various fields, it is very useful to mankind. Three main critical research areas of biotechnology. First one, that is providing the best catalyst in the form of improved organism, usually a microbes or pure enzyme. You know about the meaning of catalyst, which increase the rate of activity, and very well known example, that is biomolecule enzyme. Second one, creating optimal conditions through engineering for a catalyst to act. So, by using this type of various technology deals with biotechnology, this way this type of optical conditions they are created. Third one, downstream processing technologies to purify the protein or organic compounds. In chapter number 11, in recombinant DNA technology, we have already studied about this downstream processing. So, these are main three critical research areas of biotechnological field. First, providing the best catalyst. Second, creating optimal condition. And third one, that is downstream processing technology to purify protein or organic compounds. Biotechnological application in agriculture. As you know, our country's main food source is from agriculture area. Majority of our population, they are also farmers. They depend on agriculture to fulfill requirement of food in our population in India. To develop agriculture field is very essential. So, the naturally the food production which is provided by various agriculture field, that is not enough for this vast population. So, it is required to produce large number of food to fulfill the requirement of population, and that's why this biotechnical application in the area of agriculture, it is very important for our country. Food production can be increased by these three methods, which is dealing with biotechnological application in this field. First one is agrochemical based agriculture. Second one, organic agriculture. And third one, that is genetically engineered crop based agriculture. The main criteria of this field is actually which deals with agriculture is to avoid the harmful chemicals used as a fertilizer in the field of agriculture. We can also that can harm the plants in field also. So this way the techniques are developed which are dealing with organic agriculture. So not using harmful chemicals in this field, as well as various higher yield which can give large number of production. So various variety of plants, new species are developed by using genetically engineering technology. So this way the biotechnological applications in the field of agriculture, it is very important for our country. Green revolution succeeded in tripling the food supply, but it was not enough to feed the growing human population. You know very well about green revolution. It deals with the large food production in the field of agriculture area. So still it was not enough to fulfill the requirement of large population. Increases were partly been due to the use of improved crop variety, but mainly due to the use of better management practices and use of agrochemical smooth fertilizers and pesticides. For farmers in the developing world, agrochemicals are often too expensive, and further increase in yield with existing variety are not possible using conventional breeding. So is there any alternative path that our understanding of genetic can show that farmers may obtain maximum yield from their fields? Or we can also say, is there a way to minimize the use of fertilizers and chemicals so that their harmful effects on the environment are reduced? You can also think about this. Use of genetically modified crops is a possible solution of this problem. So various scientists, they develop various technology in the field of this agriculture, various research carried out, and then genetically modified organisms were developed. Plants, bacteria, fungi and animals whose genes have been altered by manipulation, they are called genetically modified organisms, or in short it is also known as GMO. So this way, by using these living organisms like plants, bacteria, fungi and animals, the genes, they are altered, modified, and an implication in the field of biotechnology and higher yield, higher production, higher variety, this is developed, and these are known as GMO, genetically modified organisms in short. Applications of GM plants or genetically modified plants. First, it's made crops more tolerant to abiotic stress. It means that the nature has provided some capacity to plant to fight against the abiotic stress like cold, drought, soil or heat. By using this GM plants, using this technology, so this type of crops or plants, they are improved and they become more tolerant to this type of stress, so they can grow and develop properly and give higher yield or production. Second, reduce reliance on chemical pesticides, this pest resistance crops. So various insects, pests that are actually harmful to this type of plants, crops in the field of agriculture may be reduced. Third, help to reduce post-harvest losses. By using this, maximum production is achieved. Fourth, increased efficiency of mineral usage by plants. Actually, this prevents early exhaustion of fertility of soil. So ultimately, it is very useful to crops. Fifth, enhance nutritional value of food. As for example, that is like vitamin A enriched lard. This is rice. This variety is known as golden rice. So, by using this technology, the nutritional value of food is also increased. So, this way, with various applications of GM plants, it is very useful and important in the field of agriculture. In addition to this uses, GM has been used to create tailor-made plants to supply alternative resources to industries in the form of the starches, fuels and pharmaceuticals. Application of biotechnology in product of pest resistance plants. In pest resistance plants, decrease the amount of pesticides using BT toxin, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, it's called Bacillus thuringiensis or BT cotton. Some of the application of biotechnology in the agriculture that you will study in detail also pest resistance plants. Okay, it could decrease the amount of pesticides. Okay, this Bacillus thuringiensis, it is known as BT in short. BT toxin genes has been cloned from the bacteria and been expressed in plants to provide resistance to insects without the need of insecticide, in effect created a biopesticide. Examples are BT cotton, then BT rice, tomato, potato and soybean. So this way, some this type of variety is actually developed in this way, which are actually pest resistance plant. So this way, this application of biotechnology in production of pest resistance plant, it is very useful in the field of agriculture. Now let's tell about BT cotton. What is it? You have heard this name, BT cotton is actually. Okay. Now what is exactly BT cotton? Bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis produce protein that kill certain insects such as lepidopterans, some tobacco, bollworm and armyworm. Second is Celeptodans, beetles and Diatomaceous, that is flies and mosquito. BT, Bacillus thuringiensis, form rotting crystals during a particular phase of their growth. So this type of bacterium, they grow this particular type of rotting crystals. Now what about these crystals? These crystals contain a toxic insecticidal protein. Now one question arises in our mind, why does this toxin is not kill this particular bacteria? The reason is that actually the BT toxin protein exists as inactive rhotoxin. This word is important here. It is in the form of toxic substance. It means that harmful, but which does not harm this particular bacteria because it is in form of inactive rhototoxin. It means that it is present there, but it is not in its active form. It can't react. But once insect ingests the inactive toxin, this particular, okay, it is converted into active form of toxin because the alkaline pH of the gut which solubilizes the crystals, and that's why now after injected or in the gut of this insects, this inactive protoxins of Bacillus it becomes active form of toxin. The activated toxin binds to the surface of mid gut epithelial cell. That is important here. Now this active form, activated toxin, it binds to the surface of mid gut epithelial cells and create pores that causes cell swelling and lysis and eventually cause death of the insect. So this way, now you are clear idea how this pithy cotton it is developed, why it is useful to farmers, because of its this property, this because of this toxic protein that is present in the body of this bacillus bacterium, which is actually in inactive form in the body of bacillus, but when it is ingested by insect, it is converted into an active form because of its alkaline pH of gut. It is converted into active form of toxins. It binds to the surface of mid gut epithelial cells and it creates pores, and that's why it is harmful to this insect and it causes death of insect. So this way this plant, this crop can be prevented by these insects, and ultimately the farmers can achieve large production in their field. Specific Bt toxin means they were isolated from Bacillus thuringiensis and incorporated into several crops plants. These plants such as cotton. This choice of genes depends upon the crop and the targeted pest, as most Bt toxins are insect group specific. Toxin is coded by a gene, is CRY1AC, named CRY. So CRY, that is CRY, that is important here. There are number of them. For example, proteins encoded by the genes, this is CRY1AC and CRY2AB. Control the cotton bollworms and that of CRY1AB that controls corn borer. So this way such a type of toxin coded by a gene known as CRY, and this way it can control various insects in the pest in the various agriculture field. So ultimately this type of technology developed the field of biotechnology. Okay, that is very important for agriculture field because it prevents this type of harmful effect of various insects in field, and ultimately large production is achieved. It is beneficial to farmers as well as our economy also. This figure is giving clear idea about cotton boll, the effect of such a type of bollworm. In this figure you can see the cotton boll, so final production, one side, left hand side, it is disturbed by bollworms, and another side you can see a fully mature cotton boll. So by using such a type of technology, by developing the Bt cotton, now we can understand what is its effect actually. Okay, earlier it was damaged by such a type of insects and destroyed by bollworms. So damage production all over, and another side you can see the fully or mature developed is cotton boll. So this way, so very important. Pest resistant plants. Pest means various insects which are harmful to plants, harmful to crops. Several nematodes, parasites, survive variety of plants, animals, including human beings. They depend on these organisms and shows its harmful effect. So, some nematodes, they parasitize a wide variety on plants, animal, as well as human being also. Nematode is known as Melodegine incognita. It infects the roots of tobacco plant and causes a great reduction in yield. So, this way it can damage the roots of tobacco plant and reduce the all over production. Novel strategy was adapted to prevent this infestation, which was based on the process of RNA interference. In short, it is also known as RNAi. This RNA interference takes place in all eukaryotic organisms as a method of cellular defense. So, it is one type of cellular defense mechanism. This method involves silencing of a specific mRNA due to a complementary sRNA molecule that binds to and prevents translation of the mRNA, that is silencing. Source of this complementary RNA could be from an infection by viruses having RNA genomes or mobile genetic elements, that is transposons, that replicate via an RNA intermediate. So, this way various pest resistance plant which can be developed by using biotechnology in the field of agriculture, and it is very important to obtain large production in the field. Using agrobacterium vectors, nematode specific genes were introduced into the host plant. Introduction of DNA was such that it produced both sense and antisense RNA. It is important here, sense and antisense RNA in the host cell. These two RNAs, it means sense and antisense RNA, being complementary to each other, form a double stranded. It means, in short, it is known as dsRNA, double stranded RNA, dsRNA, that initiated RNAi and thus silenced the specific mRNA of the nematodes. Constitution was that the parasite could not survive in a transgenic host expressing specific interferon RNA. The transgenic plant therefore got itself protected from the parasite. So, this way, by using this technology, the various pest resistance plants were developed. So, this type of parasites, this type of insects which damage the production in agriculture field, they could not survive in a transgenic host and expressing specific interfering RNA, and therefore they got itself protected from the parasites. So, this way, this type of variety of plants developed to this using various technologies, they are known as pest resistance plants. And main goal of this pest resistance plant actually in the field of agriculture, thus it is main thing is that this type of plants, they can protect themselves against various parasites. In this figure we can see the host plant generated dsRNA, it means double stranded RNA, triggers protection against nematode infestation. Here you can see two figures, figure A and figure B. Now, what is difference between this figure A and figure B? Study this, observe carefully it yourself, and you can come to know about this figure A, that is roots of a typical contour plants, and figure B, that is about transgenic plant roots. 5 days after the deliberated infection of nematode but protected through novel mechanism. So this is different between typical control plant and second one is transgenic plants. By comparing both plants, the root system, which we can see in figure A, root system, that is typical control plant, and in figure B, we can see the root system of transgenic plant, that roots. And now we have clear idea about what is the effect of this transgenic plant and how it is important, how it is useful in the field of agriculture.